monochrome Bitcoin ETF provides investors with a regulated pathway into the cryptocurrency market.
When you're ready to take your investments to the next level, you might want to consider monochrome.
Hello and welcome to the Global View on this Tuesday. I'm Andrew Gagan. Good to have you with us here at AusBiz as we begin the shortened trading week. Well, let's take a look at what happened overnight. Global equities mostly higher, although European shares came under pressure after far-right parties seized the ascendancy in EU elections. In the US, bond yields rose ahead of the US Federal Reserve meeting later this week. On Wall Street, the S&P 500 and Nasdaq made gains to close at new record highs. Nvidia shares ended higher after a 10-for-1 stock split, with speculation the chipmaker may be included in the blue-chip Dow Jones Index. Apple shares fell as its annual developer conference began, where it unveiled its eagerly awaited AI strategy. It said it's integrating its new Apple intelligence technology across its suite of apps, including Siri, and partnering with OpenAI to bring ChatGPT to its devices, which it says will be available later this year and that other AI features will follow. Southwest Airlines shares soared after activist investor Elliott Investment Management disclosed it had built up a $1.9 billion position in the company. Shares of Diamond Offshore Drilling jumped after oilfield services company Noble said it would buy the smaller rival in a $1.6 billion deal. That also sent Noble shares higher. And video game retailer GameStop slumped after meme stock influencer Keith Gill, otherwise known as Roaring Kitty, made his first YouTube live stream in 3 years but failed to spark investor enthusiasm. Well, US Treasury yields have risen following a stronger than expected jobs report on Friday. Investors are positioning for key inflation data out later this week, which will be followed by the Federal Reserve's policy announcement. The yield on the 10-year Treasury note rising to 4.47 and the 2-year at 4.88. And in Europe, political uncertainty has rattled markets after far-right gains in European Parliament elections, which prompted French President Emmanuel Macron to call a snap national election. Well, the results saw the euro fall to a one-month low against the US dollar, and the Aussie is at 66.1 US cents. All right, well, let's have a look at what's going on in international markets with a particular focus on Wall Street and the macroeconomic environment. At the same time, Steve Sosnick is the Chief Strategist at Interactive Brokers. He joins us now. Steve, great to catch up again, as we do on our Tuesday morning. So we've just had a holiday. In fact, we had Monday off, so we're still catching up on what happened on Friday in the States with that jobs number. What did you make of it and the market reaction?
Well, God save the Queen, so King, I guess, so welcome King. Back.
That's right.
The jobs number, it was stunning on the surface. I mean, the payrolls report was way above expectations, yet at the same token, the unemployment rate rose unexpectedly. The reason for that is there are two different means of the data collection. One is a household survey. One is a top level government, corporate survey. And so the corporate surveys basically came in saying they're adding a lot more jobs, and then the household survey said, well, we're leaving the labor force, and the unemployment rate went up. The bond market was pretty clear on how they interpreted it. Oh, because the clinching element there was monthly average earnings went up by 0.4% instead of 0.3%. So annualize that, and that makes a big difference on the inflation fighting front. So the bond market voted by basically raising rates across the board. Yields went up, call it 12 basis points, give or take here and there. And then for the most part, they continued a couple basis points higher today. Stocks generally ignored that because, one of the things we're seeing now is this, that stocks can adapt to whatever narrative they need to. If it's a strong economy, that's good for earnings. If it's a weak economy, that's good for rates. Heads I win, tails I win. And so I think we kind of have that mentality right now, even though the jobs numbers coming ahead of the Fed meeting definitely do not point to a Fed that's likely to ease.
Yeah, okay. So that's ahead of an important week, of course, with that that CPI read and the Fed meeting. So how would you describe what we saw on the equity market today then, Steve? As you're saying then, investors just looking at the positive sides regardless of what data they're getting.
Pretty much, yeah. I mean, the news from Apple today was very much a buy the rumor, sell the news story. I think there was a lot of enthusiasm ahead of their worldwide developers conference. There was nothing new and earth-shattering in there. Essentially, once more, their big announcement was essentially about paying catch-up. Last year was about virtual reality, which we really haven't seen in full force yet anyway. This year was about playing catch-up on AI. So, we did get a little bit of sell the news on that one. Nvidia, on the other hand, trading X 10 for 1 split today, that is off that going X split is often a sell the news type of event as well, because you often have rallies coming in, ahead of it, because the stock is getting more affordable, even though in this day and age it really doesn't mean too much because the you could trade small lots, you could trade fractional shares, it doesn't matter too much. But three analysts raised their price targets on it today, so that was able to turn around and go positive. And once Nvidia went positive, so did the market. Remember also, never underestimate a U.S. investor's ability to ignore what's going on in the rest of the world selectively. Ultimately, we got a bad Q out of Europe, as you mentioned, and that set a negative tone. But ultimately, I guess people said, "Well, what does a far-right parliament in Europe mean for us? Probably not that much." We, on the other hand, we were pretty good about we ignored basically what made the markets sell off in India and Mexico last week. On the other hand, the markets here, they did like the fact that the Bank of Canada cut rates and the ECB cut rates. So it's again very selective hearing when it comes to global news.
Well, speaking of selective, how's that translating as far as stocks are concerned, Steve? With certainly what we're seeing with those larger stocks in comparison, I guess, for the rest of the market.
Essentially, Andrew, I did some work today. The bigger the bottom line is, the bigger the stock, the better you've done. It's not 100% correlation because there's always exceptions that prove the rule. But when the graph that you're showing right now is the S&P 500 index in magenta and the S&P equal weighted index in the blue and white candles. And you could just see how basically over the last month or so, the index, the cap weighted index took off. That's the Nvidia factor. That's the Mag 7 factor, or more like a big five at this point. But that's, you could see they sort of moved a bit in lockstep. The S&P 500 got out to an early lead, but then they sort of started to move together. And now the market cap weighted version has just taken off. And that's really emblematic of what we've seen, because also when we start to compare the S&P 500, which in this graph is in white, to the S&P mid cap, which is in blue, and the red line, which is the S&P small cap. This is normalized year to date, and we see the S&P small cap is down about 2%, the mid cap's up about 4%, and the S&P 500 is about 12%. But that top line is the Mag 7 ETF. There's not a great proxy for the Mag 7, so this I felt was pretty much the best one I can come up with. And that's up a mere 29% year to date. So it's pretty clear that it's really, it's a very, very top-heavy market right now. And that's great if you're invested in those stocks. It's not necessarily so great because, again, it really raises the risks to the market, and I don't know what makes Nvidia stumble, but if it does, it's taking everything down with it. It's going to. Today, we got some good news out of Meta on the legal front. Nvidia rose, Microsoft rose, and so, that was enough to pull the market higher. But we're starting to see decliners outpace advancers on a fairly routine basis. It's a narrowing rally, and that's great for the broad indices, but for the bulk of your shareholdings are really not necessarily keeping pace.
So given that then, Steve, what sort of strategy can you adopt?
Well, I think, the question becomes, how long are you comfortable riding these stocks that are the winners? The history is really mixed on this. You can have long, long periods of time where very, very narrow leadership works until one day it doesn't, but it's nearly impossible to call that. So I think actually, what we have to sort of expect is that there'd be some sort of broadening out, some sort of move to defensive stocks. But what we've seen here is even some defensive sectors got caught up in AI enthusiasm, because you have utilities, essentially, they are a little bit off their highs, but they're up 12%. And it's always a little bit nerve-wracking when a sector that's supposed to be really boring, it becomes exciting, because that's telling me that something's a little strange. So I'm thinking, if you're embracing the risk, go for it. If you're not embracing the risk, make sure you're defensive, because there are definitely increasing risks out there. You know, we discussed earlier that, you know, the sell in May idea, we don't know if sell in May actually works until June at the earliest. And so far, at least in June, it's not working. But it kind of is for a broad group of stocks. It's not when you look at the indexes as benchmarks.
Steve, great to get an insight into your strategy. Thanks for joining us from Interactive Brokers.
Thanks, Andrew. Talk again soon.
All right, let's just take a quick look at where we're likely to open, given it is that shortened week. We are playing catch-up, given we had Monday off, and SPY futures currently around 0.4% lower. So we are expecting a negative start to the week. And stay with us, because the open is just a couple of minutes away.